Alright, so today I got a package in the mail from FedEx, or sorry, the United States Postal Service, actually. And it is from Missouri Wind and Solar. It's my new charge controller for my wind turbine and solar panel set. So I'm just gonna open it up here. And yes, I already opened it up once and went through it all just to make sure everything was good. So it gives you a printed off manual here, and it's a Coleman Air Diversion Controller model C160M version 4.3 with extended diversion mode. And this is all the blueprints of how it works and why it works and how to hook it all up and everything. Shows you how to hook it up if you're using it just for a diversion load for a wind turbine, or if you're using it just for the solar setup. And then on this page, it does a solar and wind turbine setup. So it is a multi-use charge controller, and you can also use this with a hydro system as well. So I could hook up a wind turbine, a hydro turbine, and a solar system all at once with this setup. It does 160 amps. Or 3600 watts. So let's go ahead and pull it out of here. This is Missouri Wind and Solar's business card right here. And if you want the information, just send me a PM and I'll send it to you. So here's the charge controller. And basically, this switch right here turns on and off the LED display. That's all it does, is just turn on and off this display. It doesn't turn on and off the box itself. This switch right here, you can press and hold the switch for 5 seconds, and it'll put it in the test mode. And then one green flash means the battery's low. And then it has a series of different flashes tell you how much percentage that the battery is in, and you can tell by this little grid here. Five flashes mean it's 80%, and if the light green light comes on and stays on, the battery bank is 100% full. And the red light comes on, this red LED light right here comes on, that means it's in dump mode. And dump mode means it's taking the excess power. When the batteries are fully charged, you don't want them to overcharge. That's the point of having a charge controller. So it's going to take that excess power and run it to a dump load. In our case, our dump load is going to be a refrigerator freezer for now, just for starting off. And once we get an idea of how much excess power we're going to have, if any at all, then we will decide whether or not to get an actual diode or transistor dump load switch setup or whatnot. So there's all kinds of things you can use for dump loads, depending on how much extra power you have and what you need to dump. So we're going to wait to see what we have to determine what we're going to use. For now, we're just going to use the refrigerator. So to hook this thing up, basically our solar panels would come in, go in one of these holes, connect to this. And then this would connect to the battery positive and battery negative. Our wind turbine is going to go in and connect to battery positive and battery negative. And then this is going to monitor the battery power and tell us when the batteries is completely charged. This will disconnect the solar panels from the batteries. And then when the wind turbine is still going to be charging the batteries, this will, acknowledge that and say, okay, well, there's power going into the batteries. We need to discharge that power, and it'll send anything extra, any excess power to the dump load. So this way, we won't fry any batteries. We won't fry any of our electrical systems or anything like that. And it's basically designed to be completely user-friendly and maintenance-free and all the other stuff, so we can hook it all up, set it and forget it for the most part. We do want to monitor it once in a while. So this right here is a voltmeter. It'll tell us what the, how many volts are in the batteries. And let's see. That way we can, we'll know what our charge rate is. We'll know if we need to turn off some stuff or unplug a few things, or we'll know if we can plug in a few things for that matter. I know my recommended maximum charging voltage for the two batteries that we've got, our AGM solar deca batteries, is 14.2 volts. And this will charge up to 14.2 volts, and then anything over that will send to our dump load. And let's see. Our solar panels are 17.2 volts, 10 amps each, and 50 watts each. So our maximum, our current solar panel arrangement that we have coming in the mail, which should be here in a couple of days, is 100 watts, 20 amps, 17.2 volts. And what this will do is arrange, it will control that so that it only goes 12 volts, no more than 14.2 volts going to the batteries, and so that we don't fry them. Let's see here. We'll also hook up the amp meters that we showed in the in another video and the unboxing of this package here, which I said was from FedEx, but it turns out it's also from United States Postal Service as well. So the boxes are very close to each other and looking. So anyways, I'm really happy with the box, and that's pretty cool. With the amp meters, it would go solar panel, amp meter, junction box, charge controller, battery, power inverter. And then with the solar panel, it's going to go solar panel. Then from the solar panel, it's going to go to the, or sorry, not the solar panel. It's going to go wind turbine brake, three phase something or other, then the amp meter. And then the amp meter to the battery, and then from the battery to a fuse box, and then the fuse box to the charge control, to the power inverter. So, and then this connects to the battery as well. And then everything, the wind turbine, this thing, and the solar panels will all go, all the grounding, or the negative leads anyway, will all go to the negative side of the battery. The positive of the wind turbine goes to the positive of the battery. The positive of this goes to the positive of the battery. And that'll be done. We could also hook up the hydro turbine straight to this. Well, we'd hook it up the same way we'd hook up the wind turbine as well. So there's many, many options we can do with this. It will run wind turbine, solar turbine, wind turbine, hydro turbine, and solar panel all at the same time, and which is great. And it'll also do a whole bunch of other different types of things. If we want to make take our treadmill motors and make various different types of turbines out of those, this will be able to control those charges, and in conjunction with all other stuff as well. So, alrighty, thanks for watching FixedByDoc, and have a great day.